the Cook and Garza combo seem to be really successful. Is that something that's built up in practice, or is it sort of a natural thing?
They're just both really good players. I mean, I think you have a good point there, Jeremiah. They've been playing together since June, which is a little earlier than you would be normally, because we had the four games overseas. So, you know, this is the sixth game that they've played together. But, you know, they both know how to play. They're both unselfish. They're both strong. I think their skill sets complement one another really well.
Is there any room for growth in that at all? I mean, because I know he and Cook and...
They both have room for growth, in my opinion. You know, Luka, he needs to go through it. Tyler's been through it, so you've seen a different player this year. He's really, you know, I thought he played with great pace. I say that about him lately. I've been using that with him. He waits, then he goes. He just doesn't go. He reads it, sees it. You know, he's not a packs of people. He's double team comes if they're sitting in his lap. He's finding people out of the post. If he's got space, he goes. He's getting to the free throw line. It's great to see him shoot 16 free throws too.
He's still considering what to do with Nick. He came off the bench today and played really well.
I like him off the bench. He hadn't been feeling really well. I think Ahmad's energy level at the start of the game is good. You know, that workforce last year, that combination. So I might keep doing that. We'll see.
With Moss, just precautionary?
He's just not ready yet. Yeah, he's not ready. You know, I don't think it'll be much longer. A couple more days, I'm guessing, but we'll see. He wasn't ready to go.
With the right ankle or foot for him?
I think it's a combination of both.
Seems like you need the first half kind of showed me that he's a guy you really need out there. He plays defense and can score. I mean, how important is he to this team?
Well, he's important. You know, I think what happened in the first half was they were nervous at the start of the game. Billy's got a good team, and they were nervous. They missed their first seven shots. They didn't come close. And once they settled down, and they got a couple guys that could play, and they were fresh, they were making shots. I mean, they shot a couple right in our face. To their credit, we were jacking threes, or we won for 13, I think, at one point from three until Nicholas made those last two. Maybe it was one for 12, because we were 3 for 14, and Nicholas made two at the end of the half. So, you know, I thought our energy level, whereas it needs to improve when the three ball's not going, you know, I think that affected us. And they started running their stuff, and we weren't taking them out of it. So second half did a much better job. I thought we ran the fast break better in the second half. We mixed our in and out better in the second half. And you got a lot of good play from a lot of different people.
Did you like that big lineup of Bear and Nungy on the wing? Did
you
try that a little bit?
Yeah. You know, I like Nungy at the three. You know, the problem is I like Nick at the three. I like Ahmad there. You know, we're going to have to utilize all of that. Jack could be a really good four as well. So could Ahmad. You know, Dom, I thought, came in the first half and played really well defensively. You know, he didn't. You know, he took a shot. Took one shot there at the end, but and he was a factor, and he'll be a factor.
On that same note. Is now going to real games coming up. We've talked to you about this a little bit before, but it seems like it's going to be a challenge for you as a coach to juggle this whole thing, keep egos or whatever. I don't know if egos is the right word.
So far, it hasn't been a problem. Yeah. You know, I understand what you're saying. I mean, there's times when I'm, you know, thinking about getting guys in. I kind of wanted to let Luka and Tyler go back in, but. I also wanted, you know, I don't want to get hurt either when you're. I also wanted to get Cordell and, you know, Ryan Kreener. You know, in the beginning he was going really fast. And once he got himself settled down, he was really good. So if you yank him, you know, when he's going too fast, and he doesn't benefit from this experience. So he settled down and was really at 9 rebounds. I mean, he was tremendous. but he wasn't tremendous immediately when I put him in. And that's I think a more important thing to try to get figured out. You know, there were times when in the first half, really the only guys who were scoring were Luka and Tyler. So you want to leave them in, you know, not to the point where they might get tired, because defensively we weren't connected at all. But you got to give, you know, Belmont Emmy some credit. Billy runs good stuff. You know, they spread us out and they made some tough shots. You got to give them credit for that.
Did these two games clarify anything in your mind in terms of rotation and combinations, or are still kind of
No, because I got a whole bunch of good players and I'm going to play them all. You know, and sometimes some less than others. You know, I mean, obviously, you're in a tight game. You know, you want to, Luka and Tyler really show what they can do. You know, but so do Cordell, Jack, and Ryan.
Jordan, kind of quiet game.
He did. You know, he's had four assists in the first half, 5-1, so that was good. He didn't shoot it a bunch. I thought he was solid. You know, but the good thing about him is he wasn't hunting shots. You know, we kept throwing the ball inside, and that's what we wanted to do.
Is there anybody you'd consider redshirting at this point, or is everyone going to play
another? I think everybody's going to play. I haven't really talked to anybody about it.
Wrestle with this at all, or was it pretty easy?
Well, to me, I didn't. It wasn't about me, so it was all about him. He recognized that Christian leaving created an opportunity for another ball handling guard to contribute to this team. He wants to contribute to this team. He loves this team. But you know, he was all in with baseball. What, you know, what we keep using that, but what does that mean? That means he went to practice for, you know, 4 hours a day, 5 days a week for a month. So he had an opportunity to grow within that program and get to know those guys and the culture and the teaching that Coach Heller employs, and you know, he's finding himself learning a lot. So that, you know, that was hard, you know, because he decided to commit there, but you know, Coach Heller was great. He said, "Look, he's going to play, and then he needs to play." You know, you got to love one of the comments that Rick made was, you know, we look at our athletes being in competitive situations and learning how to compete, and that's a very astute observation from a guy that's had great success. So that's what he wants for his guys, and you know, he may end up playing baseball. A lot of things. You know, quickly he gets a swing down at this level, and does anybody get hurt? God forbid, you don't let anybody get hurt, but that's why you have depth.
Okay, thank you, Coach.